Hello, I'm Sophie Ellis-Bextor, and this is my Tippic story. It's murder on the dance floor, but you better not kill the groove. So I started singing at 16 in the band The Audience, which was a kind of guitar, pop, indie band. If you can't do it when you're young. Because this is the 90s and that's very much the thing I was into, and I still love indie music now. But then when that band split up, I was left a bit high and dry, and then I was sent a dance track called Groove Jet, which they were looking for a singer to sing the top line. And I just thought, actually, there's something about this track I really like. And I really liked the fact that it was another world away from indie. So between my experience with my band and doing that house track, I realized, oh my words, I want to make pop music. So now I sort of do disco, dance, pop, because then I get to basically do all of it. we would do our singles and then also do a version of them in French. So yes, I have sung in French, and in fact our first ever festival was a festival in France. So yeah, that became a little thing that we would do. It was quite hard to sing in French. I did a cover of a Jacques Dutronc song called Je suis content, and I remember we did a song called A Pessimist is Never Disappointed. Yeah. Une pessimiste n'est jamais déçue. But I think beyond that I'm a little limited, I'm afraid. Misérable, un pessimiste n'est jamais déçu. The Groove Jet is the song I always say is the one that kind of changed everything for me. Not just because it actually became very successful and took me off on an adventure, but also because it introduced me to the world of dance music, which in turn led me to disco and pop, and it just kind of changed my perspective really. And it was just a really happy, exciting, crazy time. And I don't think I'd be doing what I do now if it wasn't for that song and that experience. So Murder on the Dance Floor came into my life when I was making my first record. That was an album called Read My Lips. And I was starting songwriting, and my record company said to me, oh, you have to listen to this song. It's not finished. It's a little basic demo that was done by a guy called Greg Alexander. And I knew Greg because he was the singer in the New Radicals. So he very generously let me get involved. We finished the song together, recorded in the studio. And yeah, it became this really defining song for that album, because I'd already done Take Me Home. So I think between Take Me Home and Murder on Dance Floor, it was like starting to set out my stall of what kind of album I was making. So yeah, it's always been a very happy, happy friend of mine. So I think all I knew about Greg Alexander before Murder on Dance Floor was just You Only Get What You Give, which I think is just such a classic, brilliant song. You got the music in you. Don't let go. You got the music in you. But I also knew him as a songwriter. He'd written a couple of other pop things for some other artists at that time. But actually, Greg and I just really clicked, and we ended up writing a lot of songs together. Things like Music Gets the Best of Me, and Won't Change You, and Mixed Up World. And yeah, it was really a really happy chapter, actually. I think I chose disco when I started looking at my own, where I was going to, sort of what genre I was going to explore for my own stuff, because for me, disco was all about the storytelling. I love listening to the old songs, and it would be this voice of experience with a cautionary tale, or talking about love or heartache or all these life experiences. And I thought that really intrigued me. I thought, I want to tell stories like that. So yeah, I still aspire to it now. I think it's just magic. I have seen Saltburn. I went to see an early screening of it after I'd already given permission. So I was thinking, oh, I hope I like it. And I just thought it was brilliant. I really love the way Emerald Fennell tells the story. I think the characters are brilliant. I think it's funny and it's twisted and it's dark. And it's, yeah, it's very much my kind of film. So seeing all the videos on TikTok has been glorious. And I love how people have interacted with Murder. And, you know, anyone that's done anything, like the covers people have done, dance routines, anything, all of it's brilliant. I think my favorite things have been a combination of seeing unexpected people use the song. I think one of my favorite videos was actually, it was in America, and it was a load of cars queuing up at a Taco Bell, and each of the cars had Merge on Dance were playing on their car radio, and all of the cars were like jumping, like little parties in each car. It's just crazy. Like, it's brilliant that I get to see that. It's a Merali dance floor. Oh, blimey. I mean, I think it's just been amazing where my music has gone already. So where would I like it to head? I mean, I feel like I've kind of peaked a little bit by having someone do like a completely naked dance to a song. So what can be else done? What could be next? I suppose the ultimate rebellion would have to be doing it with all your clothes on. People can do whatever they want to my music. It's fine. Take it. Enjoy it.